Hi Pisces, welcome to January 2019 and Happy New Year! Woohoo! Here we are in the new year and the universe wants for you to hold your head high and go out and meet those people who are going to make your goals real. That's because there's a huge focus going on in the area of your goals, of your hopes and wishes, with this Capricorn solar eclipse. This is the first eclipse of the year. There's going to be three of them in this area this year. This first one in January, on January 5th and 6th. Then there'll be another solar eclipse in this area on December 26, 2019, and a lunar eclipse in this area in July 2019. Mercury joins the party on the 4th, and so you have Mercury, Saturn, Sun and Moon coupled together, and Pluto all in this area of your hopes and wishes, your goals. And that's why the universe wants for you to go out and network and meet other people who can help you achieve your goals this year. And this is a very important month. These next few months and this year, 2019, you're setting the tone, you're setting the foundation for what you will create in this next 20-year cycle. Because Jupiter is going to move into Capricorn at the end of this year, and he's going to join Saturn and Pluto and initiate a new 20-year cycle with them. So this is very important. This is a new beginning. This is a fresh start. And what you do will be very significant in the weeks, months, and years ahead. Dun, 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 dun. No pressure. And you can do it. Now, with Saturn running the show, Saturn is running Capricorn. Saturn is the avatar of Capricorn, the significator, the ruler. And it's a Capricorn moon, so that brings us to Saturn, and Saturn is direct and in his own sign, and he's in the second chapter. He's almost at 12 degrees, Capricorn, making him incredibly powerful. So he is working with you on strategy, on achieving your goals, on achieving your priorities. Like, what are my priorities? How am I going about it? How am I going to make this goal or these goals a reality? Saturn is the one that helps you make your dreams come true. He examines and tests what he touches, and he's right in there with you in this area of groups that you belong to, friends, networking, the money you make from the business you own or the money you make from the company you work for, your ideals, sudden luck, sudden opportunity. So there's a message in here for you this month and next month, very big, about working with groups. By working with groups, you can see tangible, profitable results. Yay! I love that. That's really good. It's exciting. It is about playing the long game here, though. This is not about short-term payoff. This is about, you know, where am I going to be in 3 months, 6 months, a year, 5 years, 10 years, 20 years? Where do I want to be? And so this is about thinking long term in whatever you're deciding. And of course, Saturn rewards patience, perseverance, hard work, which is all about self-mastery. This is teaching us self-mastery. So this is teaching you to have mastery over your emotions, behavior, so that you are going after what you want and seeing the success that you deserve. And so the universe wants you strong, holding that head up high, and out there letting the world know that you want to work together. You want to work with others. And you will attract people that will help you make your goals real. But it is about you taking the bull by the horns. And I see you really doing that next month too, which can surprise people too, because you're going to be, especially next month, really aggressive. Like, I'm going after what I want. I'm not waiting. And that is surprising to others, that you're just not waiting for it to come to you. You're just like, I'm making it happen. I'm going to make this happen. And you will. You will make it happen. And then you feel really good because you're like, wow, I relied on myself. And look where it got me. And I'm bringing in great people to work with me. Hey, this is really cool. And it is. And it's good. Now, Uranus moves direct on the 7th. All the planets are direct. All the planets are direct. January 7th through March 6th, the first planet to go retrograde will be Mercury. And that means go after whatever you want. This is the time to launch. This is the time to start a new job. This is the time to interview. This is the time to go after what you want. This is the time to promote yourself in the world. Promote what you're doing. Promote your business. And it's exciting. It is the time to do it. This is the best time of year to start anything new. Doesn't mean we can't start things new throughout the year, but this really is the best time when all the planets are direct. Nothing is moving backward. Everyone is moving forward. It's very good. It's very strong. And exciting. Venus enters Sagittarius on the 7th, and this is really good because you have Jupiter in this area all year. Jupiter is working really hard for you this year and next year, and it's all about growing what you do in the world, growing your business, growing your presence in the world, moving up in what you're doing. This is the time to go after it. Take that bull by the horns. Go for the brass ring. Go for the gold. Go for the gusto. I had to throw that in. And see what happens. This is super exciting because they're going to unite at the time of the Leo lunar eclipse. I'll talk about that in a minute, which is really beneficial in the area of your destiny in the world, your profession in the world, your reputation in the world, your career legacy. Woohoo! Your individual unique contribution to humanity, society. I love it. Now, it is a bit bumpy in here this month because Saturn is going to merge with the Sun on the 2nd. We've got an eclipse on the 5th and the 6th. Then the Sun couples with Pluto on the 11th, and then it gets whacked by Uranus on the 18th. And so it's going to be like, hey, up and down a bit. But it can be fun and exciting too. And if something completes, eclipses complete things and they begin things. And if something completes, it's the hand of God. It's destiny saying you don't need to be there anymore. If something continues, that means you're on the right path. You're going in the right direction. Remember now, you're building the foundation for a new life. All of us, we are. And so we want to get off to a good start. We want to let go of what's no longer serving us. Stop trying to, you know, give mouth to mouth to the dead horse on the side of the road. It's gone. It's over. And so get going. Get moving. And let go of what no longer serves you. Let go of what is not part of the big picture, the big vision that you have for yourself and your work and your relationships and creativity and all of it. Very important to do. Now, there is a challenging aspect in here with Jupiter is now fighting off with Neptune because Jupiter is in Sagittarius, Neptune is in Pisces. Both of them rule their own sign, and so they're both positioned to be stubborn. This is like the trade wars going on with China and America, which is completely stupid because we're all in this together, and it's not good. All the economies are connected now. There's no America's got an economy and China's got an economy. All of our economies are connected throughout the entire planet. We're all connected. And even if we don't agree with policies, we need to find the middle ground. We need to work towards solution so that the economies continue to grow and blossom and prosper. And that is what we want for all economies everywhere on this planet, because the more prosperity in the world, the more people can buy our products and services. So it's a win-win. So we want China to be strong, America to be strong, Europe to be strong, all countries to be strong. And so this is not good, but it is what it is. And so it goes exact January 13th, June 16th, and September 24th. So we're going to see more stupid going on in the world with our leaders entrenched in their righteousness, entrenched in their position. And I'm not saying I agree, you know, with anything. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not saying I'm on any side here. I want success for everyone. And yes, I want China to play fair. However, I don't think what we're doing is the way to go about it. There has to be better ways to bring them to the table and have them, you know, cooperate more than what we're doing. All I'm saying is because of the planets, I can see how people can get entrenched. Now, that's something for you to consider, too, is not to just give up on what you want, you know, because someone else has a different opinion than you, or someone wants something different than you. Hear them out, but don't you be the first one to sacrifice. Don't be the first one to go, oh, okay, we'll do it your way. Really own, you know, Neptune is in your sign, and Neptune rules Pisces. Own your reality. Own your opinions and what you believe. And, you know, if you know, you're partnering with someone at work and they see it differently, that's fine. We don't all have to agree. The age of Aquarius, we're all in harmony together. It doesn't mean we all agree on everything. We find ways to work together. We support our differences. But we come to the same solution of cooperation, communication, conversation is the way we solve things, not I'm in my camp, you're in your camp. Is what we're seeing now. Not good, not good. And so be aware of any kind of over-promising or someone over-promising to you and not showing up and doing what they agreed to do. That's, you know, that can be it. Venus also joins the party starting on the 7th. And so that can be it too, where, you know, someone says they're going to do something at work and then they don't do it. Make sure everybody, don't go do their job too, even though, you know, you agreed to do this and they agreed to do that and they didn't do it. So now you're doing their job and your job. No, you got to let them know, hey, this is what we agreed to. This is the agreement. And you need to pull your weight here. You need to do your part in the relationship. And, you know, don't step over it. Because Saturn will hold you to the metal here. Because Saturn is, you know, up there with you. And he's like, wait a minute. This isn't going to get you what you want if you're doing all the work in your relationships. At work, at home, wherever. You know, you're not here to do it all. You do your part. They do their part. It's called teamwork. And don't let others put their work on you. I don't really see you doing that either. I see you really standing in your power this year, this month, next month, and so on. Like really owning your power and going, hey, wait a minute. This is what we agreed to. This is the agreement. And, you know, if you can't do it, you need to find someone else who can. You know, it's like being in a play. You play your part. You can't play everybody else's part too because they don't show up. You know, well, you know, I'll play the guy, I'll play the girl, I'll play the child, I'll play the mother, I'll play... No, you got to play your part. So be aware of that. It goes exact the 13th of January, June 16th, and the 21st. Then the sun moves into Aquarius on the 20th, and now you're getting ready for your birthday cycle. Very exciting. And we have the total lunar eclipse in Leo. This is the last one. Now, this is in the area of your health and your work. Pisces work like Leos. When it comes to your work, you're a lion. And something could be completing for you. This is an emotional cycle that's completing for you, and you feel really good. Like you feel lighter after this full moon. You're like, whoa, whatever I let go of, maybe it was telling someone they need to pull their weight at work. You know, something to do with work and taking care of you. That life-work balance is coming up big here at the end of the month. How can I take better care of me? And, you know, Uranus is in here with a wild card. Uranus is forming a grand square to the sun in Aquarius, the moon in Leo, Pallas Athena in Libra, the asteroid, and She is also the wise strategist. So this is a month about strategy. Think long term. Think strategy. Make sure that, yeah, you're not jumping over and doing overwork. That's not a good strategy. That's not a wise strategy. And yes, you want to do your work, but you don't want to overextend yourself. And this full moon could be bringing some sort of completion at work for you, where you complete a project, you complete a job, maybe you move offices, you move, you know, or you change how you work. Maybe there's new technology that's coming in here for you in the new year that you're using now, and it's making your life easier because you have this new technology and you feel lighter. You're going to feel lighter at this Leo lunar eclipse and after it. You're going to have this lightness where you just feel, ah. And another amazing thing that's happening here is Venus couples with Jupiter and it goes exact at this Leo lunar eclipse. Yay! Now, there could be some sort of promotion for you at this time, where you move up in what you're doing. And either your business expands in January, or you get a promotion in what you're doing, or you get your ideal job. You know, you get hired into a great position. Something really good is happening for you in the area of your reputation in the world, your profession in the world, your destiny in the world. And it is going to pay off for you too, because it's in harmonious energy flow with Mars in Aries, who's in the area of your money. Now, there could also be some surprise expense in here too with Mars there, but you'll, whatever comes up, you'll have the money for it. And remember, the more you hustle, the more you earn. Mars is about action, and he's in Aries now, and so it's easier to take that action and make it happen. And he is in harmony with Venus and Jupiter, which is so exciting, like so awesome, rockin' awesome, fantastic. And you definitely want to take advantage of these energies and go out and make it happen. And you will move up in what you're doing. You will get hired. If you're out there and you're competing with others, you're going to shine like a light bulb. You're going to shine like the sun. You're going to be glowing. They're going to be like, oh, we got to get that Pisces in here. Man, that Pisces is amazing. Let's get them hired, get them plugged in, get them going. It is. It's really that good. I love this Venus-Jupiter aspect for you, because it's right there in one of the best parts of your chart that you can get. Because, you know, if we work, I mean, for those of you retired, you can go out and do some great, you know, work with others. But when you're building a business or moving up in what you're doing, and working to make a living, there's nothing better than having Jupiter there. And then Venus, you know, it's like your fairy godmother and your fairy godfather get together and they grant your wishes. And this is about your destiny in the world and what you do in the world. Yes, it could also be about, you know, a marriage proposal. But I see more of it having to do with financial gain, reputation gain, status gain, where you're just seen as someone who's really accomplished and knowledgeable and upbeat and positive, and people are really drawn towards your light because you are so good at what you do. And don't forget to have fun too. That Leo moon is about having some fun, because we can get pretty serious in here with all of this Saturn energy and eclipses going on. And remember, if something ends and something begins, that's the hand of Creator moving you along your divine destiny, along your path, in perfect timing. Mercury joins Aquarius on the 24th. And then the final aspect in here, which I love, is Saturn is sextile Neptune. Saturn is helping you, Pisces. And this is exact January 31st. June 18th and November 8th, this energy is on all year. And unlike when Saturn was in Sagittarius and they were fighting with each other, they're now in a very lovely conversation. And Saturn is saying, okay, Pisces, what's your dream? Oh, that's a good dream. Let me help you make it real. Let me help you achieve what you want. And Saturn is supporting you. Saturn is sextile your planets in Pisces. And he's in the area of goals and career achievement and making it happen. So Saturn can bring you to what you want. Saturn can make your dreams real. Saturn can make your hopes and wishes come true. And we do it through practicality, perseverance, sacrifice, hard work, commitment, all those Saturn words. And we do it by step by step, playing the long game and building. Saturn is the master builder. Neptune is about the dream. It's about the vision. It's about creativity and spirituality. Saturn is about making it real. Dream it, we can do it. If you dream it, we can build it, says Saturn. Love, Saturn. So for those of you open for love, anything's possible. You've got the North Node in that area of true love and romance, and you're shining bright this month. You're out there networking, so you absolutely could be bumping into someone new and exciting and interesting for you. And you'll meet that person through work. You'll meet that person through networking and, you know, socializing. So get out and meet the new people coming into your life that the universe is waiting to bring to you. For those of you coupled, you know, I'm not seeing many challenges, really. It's just good. You're very focused on what you're doing. You're excited about what you're doing. You're going out doing your thing, which makes you a better partner. Money, I see a big increase in money coming in here for you in the latter part of the month. Yes, there'll be some surprise expenses with Mars, but you'll have the money to pay them. And the more you hustle, the more you earn. Career is off the charts. Career is spectacular this month and next month for Pisces. This is the time to go for it. Go after whatever it is you want, because you can make it. You can make it happen. You can make it big. You can make it grow. Stay positive and get out there. It's so exciting. Spiritually, you know, especially by the end of the month, take that time to meditate. Take that quiet time each day. Take that time to focus. Be grounded. So it'll be really wild in here in January. These energies are going to be popping us out of our body, you know, and so you really want to take that time to ground, center, be focused, so that when you strike, you hit your target, because you have tremendous support from the universe. They want to see you win, Pisces. The universe wants you to win. The universe has your back. So thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. Thank you for liking, favoring, sharing my videos. Pisces, you're rocking awesome. Thank you for subscribing. You totally rock. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do. It helps to support the channel, and it lets you know when I upload. And I'm getting ready to launch my Wealthy Biz Goddess Masterclass, and I'm doing a free webinar series at the end of the month, and I would love for you to be part of it. It's very easy. You sign up for my free email below, and when you do, you get the 7 Secrets to Magic Money Making as my gift to you. So until next time, Pisces! It's so amazing for you this month and next month. I can't wait to come back into February. It's exciting. Just get out there and show the world what you can do, and watch what happens.